Hey guys, welcome to my channel. It's all about being passionate. I'm Dr. Rishika and today we are going to talk on a condition which is found very commonly, for example, in every 3 or 4 females out of every 10. Yes, I'm talking about the breast lump. And for discussing on this topic, we have Dr. BS Giridhar from St. Martha's Hospital, Bangalore. He has been working here for the past 37 years. So let's go and meet him. So sir, tell us, what are the different types of breast lumps that are usually found or noted in females?
Now, the breast lumps can be of various types. It can be inflammatory, like breast abscess. The most common cause of breast abscess is in lactating mothers, where the milk can collect in the tubes and can give rise to abscess, or a routine abscess infection like anywhere else, or it can be traumatic following some injury where they can develop a blood clot in the breast, or there is some amount of fat necrosis where the patient can present with a lump, or they can come with multiple lumps which are benign, which is related to the hormones, or they can present with a solitary lump or multiple lumps which can still be cancer.
Okay. So I think guys, breast lump is very well explained by sir. And so let us ask him, how do these patients present to the doctor?
Now the most common presentation is incidental. Like when the lady is examining the breast on her own or taking a bath, she notices the lump. The other way it can present is they notice some pain or vague discomfort. The third one is, especially when they are the benign lesions called fibrocystic disease or fibroadenosis, which is related to the hormonal changes in the body. During menstrual cycles, they come with discomfort and pain in the breast. And if they are lactating and if the milk collects in the breast, then they come with painful infected lumps. If the one thing you must know is cancer does not present with pain as the first symptom. It is always the patient presents with a lump, painless lump. So whenever the woman notices a lump, they should go to a doctor just to clarify what it could be.
At least they need to evaluate. So what are the general investigations for these lumps?
See, basically in any breast lump, it is the clinical evaluation which is very important. The concerned doctor has to examine the patient properly and come to a clinical diagnosis. Am I treating with something which is benign, or am I treating something which is malignant? But the dictum now is any lump felt in the breast, we have to rule out malignancy. Though clinically the doctor is sure it is not cancer, we have to rule out cancer, because the early treatment for cancer, the prognosis is good. Now, the first line of treatment, as I said, would be the investigation, would be the clinical evaluation, followed by now what we call the needle biopsy. It is called the FNAC, fine needle aspiration cytology, where the doctor puts in a fine needle into the lump, takes a little tissue for examination, which the pathologist will give us a rough idea whether we are dealing with a benign condition or we are dealing with a malignancy. Now, once it comes as benign, depending on what the pathology is, we just continue with treatment with no further evaluation. But whenever there is a doubt or the patient persists to be symptomatic, then we have to remove that lump for biopsy. The whole lump has to be removed for biopsy. If it comes as cancer, then we have to go through a full evaluation where there are various tests like mammogram, CT scan, then tumor markers, all that which will be taken care of by the treating doctor.
So, do we need to do mammograms in case of benign lumps, or it is just for the malignancies?
Mammography again is an investigation which is reserved for malignancy. Only when we have doubt, where the pathologist is not able to clarify or give us a clear picture whether we are dealing with benign or malignant, then mammogram shows certain features which are characteristic of malignancy. When we say mammography, we mean both the ultrasound and the X-ray mammogram, where we get certain features which pinpoint towards malignants.
Can you tell us what are the possible treatment options for these lumps?
Now, as I mentioned, the lumps can be benign or cancerous. In the benign, again, we have inflammatory lumps like abscess which needs to be drained, or multiple aspirations have to be done. If it is hematoma, we wait and watch. Many a time the clot dissolves on its own. If it gets infected or becomes painful or it is increasing in size, then we intervene. Now, if it is benign disease, where we are sure it is a benign disease by histopathology, there are multiple nodules in the breast, patient is asymptomatic, we do not do anything. Like multiple fibrocystic disease or fibroadenosis, and the patient is asymptomatic, treatment is wait and watch. We don't do anything for that. If the patient complains of pain, like I told you earlier, that during menstrual cycles, they get breast congestion with pain, discomfort, there we ask them to wear a proper breast support and take care good analgesics. It is only symptomatic treatment for these conditions. Only when the lump becomes big or we have a doubt of a change, malignant change, or we have missed a diagnosis, that is then we operate on these patients. But if it comes as cancer, then our management options are completely different. We have treatment options in case of breast cancer, if detected earlier or a bit late. The mainstay of any breast cancer surgery would be, of breast cancer would be surgical management. The other parts of the treatment which go along with surgical management is going to be radiotherapy, chemotherapy, and hormonal therapy. Now, that depending on the type of tumor, the clinician decides what is to be done. We get a lot of patients who are taken local treatment like homeopathy, Ayurveda, everything. Though they have a place, I don't know, most of them come to us in an advanced disease where the treatment options get limited. So if they come to the clinician early, diagnosed early, treatment plan can go according to schedule and the prognosis is quite good.
Okay, sir. So can you elaborate on the prognosis of these lumps?
The benign lumps, they usually have no problem. They get along fine, especially the fibroadenosis, fibrocystic disease. As long as the patient is having the menstrual cycles and they are under the influence of the hormones, especially estrogen, this will continue. And once the cycles are over, most of the time they disappear. It is only symptomatic treatment for these benign diseases, like I have told earlier. And in case of cancer, like again I have mentioned, early diagnosis, prognosis is good. Late diagnosis, the treatments are limited.
So, can you tell us the role of self-examination for breast lumps?
Yes, self-examination is a very important thing for all women, as breast cancer has no age bar. Anyone, once they start having their cycles, even after menopause or the cycles have stopped, they are prone for malignancy. So all women should know how to examine the breast. They can speak to the doctor, they can be taught the actual method of doing it, and they can self-examine themselves once in 2 to 3 months, and whenever they have a doubt, they get back to the clinician.
So, once treated, can these lumps recur?
Yes, they can, because they are under the influence of hormones, and the hormones act on the whole breast, the parenchyma of the breast. So it doesn't mean that if I have removed the lump now, it is not going to come back. Especially in the benign conditions like fibroadenoma, it can be single. When you remove it, it can come in the same place or somewhere else in the breast. Or if there are multiple, we try not to remove all the lumps. Only whenever the patient becomes symptomatic, they remove. So recurrence is known in benign breast diseases. When it comes to cancer, we have to be very careful because the etiology is varied. It again depends on genetics, whether there is a family history of malignancy, especially if the mother has cancer. We have to screen all the female members on the mother's side, including all the daughters and the mother's sisters, everyone, because it is known to run in the family. Then if the the nulliparous women or women who have few children, they are prone for breast cancer. women who have not breastfed children for long term. They, most of them now are working women who do not feed their children. These are the people who have to be extra careful. And if you have been operated for breast cancer on one side, you must be careful because you can develop breast cancer on the opposite side. Diet also plays a major role, especially eating fatty food, obesity. All these are known to, the incidence of malignancy is known to be high.
Thank you so much, sir. This was a really informative session. So I hope that you all understood the importance of self-examination and the importance of reaching the clinician as early as possible. Thank you. So guys, please share this video with all your family members and all your friends around to spread a word of awareness about breast lump and breast cancer. Also, if you have any doubts related to this topic, you can comment in the comment section below and we shall get back to you.